So let us start the session. Today we are going to start revision number 1 of chapter number 5, understanding elementary shapes. So let us see the different types of questions. First is measuring line segment, okay, and the second one is angles right and straight, and the third one is direction based questions, and the fourth one is measuring angle, and the fifth one is angles acute, obtuse and reflex, and the next one is triangles, perpendicular lines, quadrilaterals, polygons, and the last one is three-dimensional shapes. So these many topics are there, and coming to triangles, we have three topics, subtopics. One is identifying the type of triangles, classification based on sides, classification based on angles. This is angles, okay? Ye angles hai. Right. And now coming to quadrilateral, we have two types. One is identifying the type and the types of quadrilaterals. Polygon, identifying the type of polygon and drawing a particular polygon. And three-dimensional shape, to find faces, number of faces, edges, vertices. So these are the different types of questions, and if you use this chart, this is actually a revision chart. Ye chart agar leke practice karoge to you can complete the revision quickly. Right, now let us move toward the first topic of measuring a line segment using ruler and divider. Okay, so suppose given a two lengths AB and CD, so what we will do, we will place the divider on AB like that. Then without disturbing the pointer, without disturbing the opening, we will lift the divider and place it on the ruler in such a way that one pointer of the divider is at the zero mark of the ruler. See, like this. Ek point hum log kya karenge, bina uska jo opening ko disturb kiye, ek pointer zero pe rakhenge aur dusra point dekhenge kahan pe aa raha hai. So we are getting 6.8, right? Now read the mark against the other pointer. This gives the length of AB. That is, AB is equals to 6.8 centimeter. Similarly, measurement of line segment CD is equals to 4 centimeter. Clearly, AB is greater than CD. Okay. So, yeah, measuring of line utna important hi exam ke liye. So now we are moving toward important questions from exercise 5.1. The third question. First, second are not important. Draw any line segment, say AB, take any point C lying in between A and B, measure the lengths of AB, BC and AD. Is AB is equals to AC plus CB, right? Now, agar AB ke beech mein agar hum log C draw karte hain, C point agar lete hain, toh definitely AC plus CB will be equals to AB, right? See this figure. Suppose AB is 7 centimeter, so AC will be, I'm going to take it as in the middle of the AB. So ye 33.5 or ye 3.5 hai, aur pura measurement iska 7 hai. So that means AB is equals to AC plus CB, right? That is 7 is equals to 3.5 plus 3.5. Now next question, question number 4. 5.1 एक्सरसाइज में कोई भी क्वेश्चंस इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है अभी हाफ ईयरली एग्जाम के लिए. सो दिस इज फॉर जस्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग. इफ ए बी सी आर थ्री पॉइंट्स ऑन अ लाइन सच दैट ए बी इज इक्वल टू 5 सेंटीमीटर, बी सी इज इक्वल टू 3 सेंटीमीटर, ए सी इज इक्वल टू 8 सेंटीमीटर, विच वन ऑफ देम लाइज बिटवीन द अदर टू साइड. सो हम लोग क्या चेक करेंगे, किसी दो का सम थर्ड है कि नहीं, राइट? सी 5 प्लस 3 इज 8. So AB plus BC is equals to AC आ रहा है. What we are getting? AB plus BC is equals to AC. और ये दोनों में B common है, देखो. B point is common. That means B is lies between AC. So this is the figure. Right? Suppose this is 5 centimeter and this is 3 centimeter. So 5 plus 3 is equals to 8 centimeter. So B lies in between the points A and C. Now the next question, verify whether D is the midpoint of AG. So ध्यान से देखो, A यहाँ पर है और G यहाँ पर है. डी से लेकर जी तक 3 यूनिट्स हैं एंड फ्रॉम ए टू डी इट इज ऑल्सो 3 यूनिट्स. ओके, ये भी 3 यूनिट्स है और ये भी 3 यूनिट्स है. सो दैट मीन्स डी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए जी बिकॉज ए डी इज इक्वल टू डी जी इज इक्वल टू 3 यूनिट्स. Right. So now we are moving toward the next topic, angle. Already in the previous chapter's revision, we have seen the angle is formed by two rays, okay, having a common initial point, which is called vertex. See this figure. This is vertex, and this is arm, and this is an angle. So the rays forming the angle are called its arms or its sides also. This is the angle. And how we name the angle? Any two points we have to take on the ray. Okay? See, this is the one example of angle from day to day life. Caesar. Caesar ke beech mein bhi ek angle form ho raha hai. And if you see here also we can assume one angle. Yahan par bhi ek angle hum log assume kar sakte hain. Aur yahan par bhi ek angle. Yahan par bhi ek angle. Okay? So this is a good example for from our day to day life. Now naming an angle, any two points, one on each of the arm. यहाँ पे हम लोग A लिए हैं और यहाँ पे B लिए हैं, right? So the angle shown in above figure is written by AOB and it is read as angle AOB. ठीक है, इसको कैसे read करेंगे? Angle AOB. So what we are observing that we are using the vertex, that is the initial point at the center. So that is the rule for writing the angle. We cannot write A B O. We cannot write O B A, right? So it is also written as angle B O A. But writing angle A B O and angle B A O is incorrect. That is wrong. And now coming to the measurement of angle. Angle measure करने के लिए हम लोग use करते हैं protractor, right? Protractor. This is the protractor, and it has two scale. One is inner scale. And another is upper scale. Okay, inner scale हम लोग कब use करते हैं? जब हम लोग left से right की ओर, right से left की ओर measure करते हैं angle को, right? इस direction में, right? इस direction में means anti clockwise. और whenever we use, we are measuring from left to right, that is anti clockwise, clockwise. जैसे ये वाला angle, तब हम लोग ऊपर वाला outer scale use करते हैं. Okay. So protractor shown in adjoining figure is an instrument used for measuring a given angle or for constructing an angle of the given magnitude. It is a rectangle, semicircular shape, aadha half circle ka shape hota hai, and it is usually made up of transparent plastic so that marking are visible when it is placed over the arms of an angle. And it has degree marks on the curved edge from 0 to 180 degree on the inner scale from 180 to 0 degree on the outer scale. Inner scale mein 0 to 180 aur outer scale mein 180 to 0 degree, which enables us to read the measure of an angle or construct an angle of the given measure. Now how to measure using protractor? Suppose we are measuring the angle AOB. So what we are going to do, we are placing this protractor so that its center is coincide with the vertex of the angle. देखो यहाँ पे ध्यान से, ये वर्टेक्स है, इसके साथ ओवरलैप होना चाहिए और ये बेस लाइन जो है ये भी आर्म के साथ में कॉन्साइड होना चाहिए. देन वी हैव टू मेजर दिस एंगल, ये वाला इस डायरेक्शन में. सो नीचे वाला स्केल देखेंगे, नीचे वाला स्केल जो है वो 60 है, राइट? सो द एंगल ऑफ एंगल एओबी इन दिस केस इज 60 डिग्री, राइट? सो नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक्स. अब यहाँ से इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक स्टार्ट हो रहा है. Right hand stretch, an angle whose measure is equals to 90 degrees called right angle. See, this is the figure. Yahan pe angle ka measure 90 degree hai, so this is a right angle. An angle whose measure is equals to 180 degree is called a straight line. And this is one example. Yahan pe ye pura straight line form kar raha hai, so this is equals to 180 degree. Right. So now the next topic is direction. There are four main directions. One is north, south, east and west. See, this is the figure. And Jammu is north to north of Delhi and Kolkata to its east. Right, Rajkot to its west and Cochin to its south. See, suppose if I'm taking this figure, you stand, this arrow mark indicate that you stand facing north, right? And suppose one right angle, if we are moving towards the clockwise, then we will come to east facing. We will come to this direction, and then we will face the east direction. So this is the diagram. By a right angled turn clockwise, you now face east, right? Again, if you rotate right angle, then again you will face south. So like that, questions are there. After turning two right angles, after turning three right angles, where you are facing. So such questions are very important. Okay, now we'll see, from facing north to facing south, you have turned by two right angles. देखो ध्यान से, यहां से यहाँ पे फर्स्ट राइट एंगल एंड द सेकेंड राइट एंगल. सो टू राइट एंगल में हम लोग नॉर्थ से साउथ की तरफ फेस कर रहे हैं. द टर्न फ्रॉम नाउ नॉर्थ टू साउथ इज बाय टू राइट एंगल्स, इट इज कॉल्ड अ स्ट्रेट एंगल, दैट इज 180 डिग्री. नाउ फ्रॉम फेसिंग साउथ टू फेसिंग नॉर्थ, अगेन साउथ टू फेसिंग नॉर्थ, अगेन यू हैव टू टर्न बाय टू राइट एंगल्स, दैट इज स्ट्रेट एंगल. ओके, देखो यहां पर थे अभी हम लोग, फिर से हम लोग यहां तक पहुंच गए, राइट? सो टर्निंग बाय टू स्ट्रेट एंगल्स इन द सेम डायरेक्शन मेक्स अ फुल टर्न, दैट इज फोर राइट एंगल्स. अगर हम लोग यहां से फुल टर्न करते हैं तो वापस उसी प्लेस में आ जाएंगे. दिस इज फोर राइट एंगल्स और टू स्ट्रेट एंगल्स. This complete turn is called one revolution, and this angle is called complete angle, 360 degree. Right. So now we are moving towards some figures which illustrates the number of degrees in angles of standard rotation. See, we are starting from here. यहाँ से हम लोग start कर रहे हैं, ठीक है? Anti-clockwise. So now is 90 degree rotation को हम लोग बोलेंगे 1/4, right? And again 90 degree, that is half rotation. ठीक है, 180 degree half rotation, 90 degree 1/4 rotation. And again if you move one more 90 degree, 3/4 rotation, that is 270 degree. Again one more right angle, full rotation, that is one complete rotation, 360 degree. Now this is very important. Now we will see the same thing in clock. The following diagram shows the angles formed by the rotation of the minute hand of a clock starting at 12. See, first quarter rotation. This is quarter rotation. Quarter ka matlab hota hai 1/4. That is 90 degree. Now one more right angle. Half rotation. Theek hai, 1/2. And one more right angle. This is 3/4. That is 3/4. 270 degree. Now one more right angle, full rotation, that is one complete rotation, 360 degree, right? So now we are moving towards some important questions from exercise 5.2. What fraction of a clockwise revolution does the hour hand of a clock turn through when it goes from dash to dash? So यहाँ पे एक छोटा सा logic याद रखो, three numbers है, ठीक है? When it is three numbers, 90 degree. When it turns 6 numbers, 180 degree. When it turns 9 number, 270 degree. ठीक है, यहाँ पे देखो 3 to 9, first वाला है 3 to 9. MCQ question में direct हम लोग को identify करके लिखना है. तो ये question exam के लिए बहुत important है. 3 to 9 means 6 number गया है. So half rotation. ठीक है, fraction होगा 1/2. And 4 to 7, only 3 numbers. So 90 degree. 1/4, fraction is 1/4. 7 to 10, again 3 numbers, 1/4, fraction is 1/4. Now I will show you in the diagram. This is the first one, theek hai, 3 se 9 mein gaya, so one straight angle we are getting, so half, 1/2. Now the next one, say 3 numbers, it shows one right angle, so 1/4. Next is 7 to 10, it shows again 90 degree, that is 1/4, 1/4 is the fraction. Okay, now we are moving toward the next direction based question. Which direction will you face if you start facing फर्स्ट ईस्ट एंड मेक 1/2 रेवोल्यूशन. देखो ध्यान से, अभी मैं ईस्ट पे हूँ राइट, और क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करना है 1/2. 1/2 मीन्स हाफ फुल, हाफ मीन्स टू राइट एंगल्स. सो वी आर रीचिंग हियर. नाउ वी आर फेसिंग वेस्ट. सो फेसिंग ईस्ट एंड ऑन मेकिंग 1/2 ऑफ ए रेवोल्यूशन क्लॉकवाइज वी विल फेस वेस्ट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वी आर फेसिंग ईस्ट एंड मेक 1/2. 1/2 मीन्स 1 फुल एंड 1/2 ऑफ ए रेवोल्यूशन क्लॉकवाइज. चलो स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं. नाउ वी आर फेसिंग ईस्ट, एक फुल रोटेशन ले लिया. नाउ हाफ रोटेशन, यहाँ तक फुल आ गया. नाउ हाफ, यस वी आर फेसिंग वेस्ट. ओके अगेन वी आर फेसिंग वेस्ट. नेक्स्ट, नाउ वी आर फेसिंग वेस्ट एंड मेक्स 3/4 ऑफ ए रेवोल्यूशन. 3/4 मीन्स 3 राइट एंगल्स. सो देखो वेस्ट से हम लोग 3 राइट एंगल्स एंटी क्लॉकवाइज बोल रहे हैं. एंटी क्लॉकवाइज मीन्स इस डायरेक्शन में राइट. 1, 2, 3. सो वी रीच हियर. नाउ वी आर फेसिंग नॉर्थ राइट. दिस इज द सी बिट. नाउ वी विल सी वन मोर क्वेश्चन. साउथ एंड मेक 1 फुल रेवोल्यूशन. जहां से स्टार्ट किए थे वहीं पे आ जाएंगे. देखो साउथ पे थे. नाउ हियर डायरेक्शन इज नॉट गिवन, मीन्स क्लॉकवाइज और एंटी क्लॉकवाइज. वी कैन यूज क्लॉकवाइज. सो वी रीच्ड हियर द सेम प्लेस. सो वी आर फेसिंग साउथ ऑन राइट. सो दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. नाउ वी आर मूविंग टूअर्ड क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. व्हाट पार्ट ऑफ ए रेवोल्यूशन हैव यू टर्नड थ्रू इफ यू स्टैंड फेसिंग ईस्ट एंड टर्न क्लॉकवाइज टू फेस नॉर्थ. सी द डायग्राम. अभी ईस्ट में है. नाउ वी हैव टू टर्न क्लॉकवाइज टू फेस नॉर्थ. 1, 2, 3. सो 3 राइट एंगल्स. 3 राइट एंगल्स मीन्स 3/4. फर्स्ट आंसर इज 3/4. नेक्स्ट वन, साउथ एंड टर्न क्लॉकवाइज टू फेस ईस्ट. सो वी आर फेसिंग साउथ. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू टर्न क्लॉकवाइज टू फेस ईस्ट. 1, 2, 3. So now we are facing east. So how many right angles? 1, 2, 3. So 3/4 of a revolution. Now the last one, west and turn clockwise to east. Clockwise to east. 1, 2. So only 2 right angles. That means 1/2 of a revolution. Okay. So now we will see clock based questions. Find the number of right angles turned through by the hour hand of a clock when it goes from dash to dash. I told you that 3 number change ho raha hai to 1 right angle, 6 numbers change ho raha hai to 2 right angles, 9 numbers change ho raha hai to 3 right angles, 12 then 4 right angles. So dekho bina draw kiye kaise batayenge. 3 to 6, 3 numbers, 1 right angle. 2 to 6, 6 numbers, 2 right angles. 5 to 11, again 6 numbers, 2 right angles. 10 to 1, 3 numbers, so 1 right angle. 12 to 9, 9 numbers, 3 right angles. 12 to 6, 6 numbers, 2 right angles. I repeat, 3 numbers, 1 right angle. 6 numbers, 2 right angles. 9 numbers, 3 right angles, right? So I will show you in the diagram. This is the first one, 3 to 6, 1 right angle. Second, 2 to 6, 2 right angles. And C, 5 to 11, again 2 right angles, 6 numbers. And next, 10 to 1, 3 numbers, 1 right angle. 12 to 9, 9 numbers, 3 right angles. And last, 12 to 6, 6 numbers, so we have 2 right angles, right. So now we are moving toward question number 6. How many right angles do you make if you start facing first south and turn clockwise to west? See, hum log abhi south mein hain aur clockwise west ke taraf aa rahe hain. So only 1 right angle. Next, north and turn anti clockwise to east. Anti clockwise matlab ulta. 1, 2, 3. So 3 right angles. Next, west and turn to west, back to the same place. So a full round, matlab 4 right angles. Next one, south and turn to north. Two right angles, south, turn to north. ठीक है, half rotation, that means two right angles. This is question number 6. Now we are moving toward the last question from this exercise. Where will the hour hand of a clock stop if it starts from 6 and turn through one right angle? तो तीन नंबर लेना है, 7, 8, 9 में रुकेगा. From 8 and turns two right angles. Six numbers count करना है. 9, 10, 11, 12 के बाद 1 आएगा. 1, 2 पे रुकेगा. From 10 turns three right angles. Nine numbers count करना है. 10 के बाद 11, 12 अगेन 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 7 पे रुकेगा. So एक बार देख लेते figure. 6 से start हुआ, one right angle, three numbers count करना है. 1, 2, 3 one right angle. From started from 8, two right angles मतलब 6 numbers, so 2 पे जाएगा. And starting from 10, three right angles, just now I told 7 तक जाएगा. Okay, so this is the 7th question. Now we are moving toward the next topic, acute, obtuse and reflex angle. So acute angle, the angle measures is greater than 0 degree but less than 90 degree, right? And example 60 degree, 30 degree, 40 degree. So this is one example. It is less than 90 degree and greater than 0 degree. We can see many acute angle in our day-to-day life. See this watermelon piece. This angle is acute angle. A crossing, a road crossing, example hai. This is also acute angle. Caesar ke beech ka jo angle hai, this is also an acute angle. And clock, the angle between this hour and minute hand, ye bhi acute angle hai because it is less than 90 degree. Right? Next, obtuse angle. Angle greater than 90 but less than 180. Example 110, 100, 140. So 140 we are taking, which because it is greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. Right? So we can see many obtuse angle in our day-to-day life. Ek ye so ek sofa hai, yahan pe dekho obtuse angle hai. This is a hanger, this is also an obtuse angle. क्लॉक में भी देख सकते हैं, दिस इज ऑल्सो एन ऑब्ट्यूज एंगल. और स्टेयर केस में भी अगर देखोगे, यहाँ पर हम लोग को एक्यूट एंगल, सॉरी ऑब्ट्यूज एंगल, दीज आर ऑल ऑब्ट्यूज एंगल बिकॉज इट इज ग्रेटर दैन 90 डिग्री. राइट, सो नाउ नेक्स्ट इज रिफ्लेक्स. ग्रेटर दैन 180 बट लेस दैन 360. ठीक है, सो एग्जाम्पल 220 एंड सम पिक्चर्स फ्रॉम डे टू डे लाइफ. दिस इज अ कंपास, अ डिवाइडर. इसके बीच का जो ये वाला एंगल है, दिस एंगल इज ग्रेटर दैन 180 degree and less than 360. An angle between this angle, this is also reflex angle. Or ye bhi ek pizza ka hai piece, ye bhi reflex angle hai, this one. Right, so now we are going to identify the angles. Okay, so we'll see few example. This is acute angle because it is less than 90 degree. This is a straight angle. This is obtuse angle, more than 90 degree. And this angle is greater than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. So it is a reflex angle. So first one acute, second straight, third obtuse, and the last one is reflex angle. Okay, so now we'll see a few questions from exercise 5.3. Match the following. Straight line, it is a half of revolution, 180 degree. Right angle is 90 degree, it is 1/4 of revolution. And acute angle, it is less than 90 degree but greater than 0 degree. Less than 90 degree matlab less than 1/4 of a revolution. So A. Next one is obtuse angle. Obtuse angle is more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. So more than 90 degree matlab 1/4 ho gaya. Or 180 degree means 1/2 of revolution. So ye wala option aega, obtuse angle. And the last one is reflex angle. Reflex angle is more than 180 degree, more than half revolution, but less than 360 degree. That is one complete revolution. So the correct option is B. So this is match the following. Now we'll see one more example to classify the angles. So first one is acute angle, more than 0 degree, but less than 90 degree. The second one is more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree obtuse angle. and this one is 90 degree right angle, and this one is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree, so reflex angle, and this is a straight line, straight angle, and this two are acute angles, right? So now we will move towards one again, measuring angles. This we have already seen how to measure these angle. क्या करना है, ये वर्टेक्स को ये सेंटर के साथ में कॉन्साइड करना है, एंड दिस बेस लाइन ऑल्सो वी हैव टू कॉन्साइड विद दिस लाइन, राइट? देखो, सो नाउ दिस इज द एंगल, और हम लोग क्लॉक वाइज मेजर कर रहे हैं. इफ यू आर मेजरिंग क्लॉक वाइज तो इनर सर्कल स्केल यूज करना है, सो वी आर गेटिंग 40, राइट? नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वॉट इज द मेजर ऑफ राइट एंगल 90 डिग्री, what is the measure of straight angle 180 degree. Now we are moving towards true or false exam mein nahi aayega. The measure of an acute angle is less than 90 degree, correct. The measure of an obtuse angle less than 180 degree, wrong, false. The measure of a reflex angle is greater than 180 degree but less than 360 degree, wo complete nahi hai, fir bhi isko tick kar lete hain, true. And the measure of an one complete revolution is 360 degree. This is also true. If the measure of angle 53 degree, angle A is 53 degree. Measure of angle A is 35 degree. So measure of angle A is greater than measure of angle B. This is true. Okay. So now we are moving towards the next question. Question number 3. Write down the measures of some acute angles. कोई भी लिख सकते हो. 30 degree, 40 degree, 60 degree, A 70 degree. Some obtuse angles, 100 degree, 95, 110, 120, 130. So I'm writing this one. Okay. Next question, measure the angles given below using the protractor and write down the measure. So now we are going to take protractor. Okay. So abhi isko hum log measure karke dekhenge. Okay. So now what we will do, we will coincide the vertex with the center of the protractor. ठीक है, एकदम धीरे धीरे प्लेस करोगे, राइट? अभी सेंटर भी कॉन्साइड हो गया वर्टेक्स के साथ में और बेस लाइन भी. नाउ विल सी द एंगल. सो दिस इज, अब देखो यहाँ पे हम लोग एंटी क्लॉक वाइज रह गए, राइट से लेफ्ट की तरफ ले रहे हैं, तो नीचे वाला स्केल देखना, ऊपर वाला नहीं. सो दिस इज 122. नाउ फॉर दिस एंगल we have to rotate the protractor. मैं rotate कर रहा हूँ. Okay, so ध्यान से देखो, अभी कौन साइड हो गया, ठीक है, थोड़ा से और चाहिए, right? अभी कौन साइड हो गया, तो ये approximately देखो यहाँ पर आ रहा है 45. So in this way you have to measure the angle. Okay, right. Now next, fill in the blanks with acute, obtuse and right or straight. First, an angle whose measure is less than that of a right angle is acute angle, and an angle whose measure is greater than that of a right angle, more than 90 degree but less than 180, is obtuse angle. An angle whose measure is the sum of the measure of two right angles, though right angles ka total 180 hota hai, to straight angle. Next, when the sum of the measure of two angles is that of right angle, then each one of them is acute angle. ठीक है, दो angle का total अगर 90 degree होगा तो वो दोनों angle जो है 90 से कम होंगे, acute angles. Now when the sum of the measure of two angles is that of a straight angle, ठीक है, दो angles का sum अगर straight angles equal 180 degree है, so one of them is acute, then the other will be obtuse. Okay, and now we are moving toward the next topic, perpendicular lines. When two lines are intersect at right angle, theek hai, when the two lines intersect and the angle between them is a right angle, then the lines said to be perpendicular. See this figure, AB and CD are perpendicular to each other. Why? They are intersecting at 90 degree. So if perpendicular line AB intersect the line segment CD at point midpoint M, अगर ये midpoint हो जाता है तो हम लोग इसको क्या बोलेंगे, perpendicular bisector, right? If perpendicular line AB intersects the line segment CD at its midpoint, then AB is called the perpendicular bisector of CD. So we'll see a few examples from exercise 5.5. Which of the following are the models for perpendicular lines? First, adjacent edge of a table top. We are getting right angle. So answer is yes, we can use. Next one, lines of railway track. They are parallel to each other. Okay, they are parallel to each other. So this cannot be used as a model. Next, L. So L ke beech mein bhi 90 degree aa raha hai. So we can use this as a model for perpendicular lines. Now, V shape. V ke beech mein hum log ko acute angle mil raha hai. The angle is less than 90 degree. So we cannot use this model for perpendicular lines. Okay, so we'll see one more question. Let PQ be the perpendicular to the line segment XY. Let PQ and XY intersect in the point A. What is the measure of angle PAY? So this is the figure. ये perpendicular है और ये वाला angle पूछ रहा है. So this is nothing but this is 90 degree. Because perpendicular तभी होगा जब they are intersecting at right angle. So angle PAY is equals to 90 degree. Next question, study the diagram. The line L is perpendicular to line M. Is CE is equals to EG? CE, देखो C, E और G. ध्यान से देखो, दोनों दो यूनिट के डिस्टेंस पे हैं. So answer is yes. Next, PE bisects CG. PE bisects CG means दोनों को इक्वल पार्ट में डिवाइड कर रहा है केंद्र. Yes, क्योंकि E मिडपॉइंट है. Next, identifying any two line segments for which PE is the perpendicular bisector. So, एक तो ये भी है, DE और EF, ये भी equal है देखो. So, DF और BH also we can write. Or, we can write, नहीं, BH बस, last. Are this true? AC is greater than FG. AC है 2 unit और FG है 1 unit. So, answer is true. Now CD is equals to GH. CD is 1 unit and GH is also 1 unit. So answer is true. BC is less than EH. BC is 1 and EH is 3 units. So answer is true. So this is the last question of today's session. We will do the remaining in the second revision. Okay. So that's all for today's session. Thank you. Thank you very much.